a responsibility. That responsibility rests upon a sovereign body representing the sovereign people of India. On 26 January 2022, India celebrates its 73rd Republic Day. I wish you all a very happy Republic Day. On this day, people of all faith, culture, community and sections of the country come together to celebrate the rich and culture of our country. Dr. Jawaharlal Nehru says, what can we have in India, whatever the state may have or may not have? It is impossible and inconceivable and undesirable to think in another terms, but in terms of the Republic in India. The governing principle of India, Indian Constitution, is of the people, for the people, and by the people, which signifies that the power is vested in the hands of the citizens of India. The preamble of the Indian Constitution declares that India is a sovereign, socialist, secular, and democratic republic and promises to secure to its citizens justice, social, economic, and political liberty of thoughts, expressions, belief, faith, and worship, equality of status and of opportunity, and to promote among them all fraternity, assuring the dignity of the individual and the unity and integrity of the nation. Today, the citizens of India have the right and the duty to live our constitutional values. It's the right time to introspect ourselves. Am I bold enough to live these values for the betterment of my brethren? Am I courageous enough to reach out to the needy? We should remind ourselves of our constitutional mantras. Let's all continue on the path of constitutional morality, which Dr. Ambedkar mentioned in his speech on the Constituent Assembly on November 4th, 1948, while presenting the draft of the Constitution. He clarified that constitutional morality means supremacy of the values enshrined in the Constitution. The service of India means the service of the millions who suffer. It means the ending of poverty, ignorance, disease, and equality of opportunity. The ambition of the greatest man of our generation has been to wipe every tear from every eye. That may be beyond us, but as long as there is tears and sufferings, so long our work will not be over. And so, we have to labor and work hard to give reality to our dreams. Peace has been said to be invisible. So is freedom. So is prosperity now. And so also is disaster in this one world that can no longer be split into isolated fragments. We must rededicate ourselves to this day, to the peaceful but sure realization of the dreams that had inspired the father of our nation and are the captains and soldiers of our freedom struggle. The dream of establishing a classes, cooperative, free and happy society in this country. We must remember that this is mourn a day of dedication than of rejoicing. Dedication to the glorious task of making peasants and workers, the toilers and the thinkers, fully free and happy and cultured. With freedom in the mind, vigor in our words, pride in our souls, zeal in our hearts, let us salute our India on this Republic Day. God bless you all. Thank you.
When we are celebrating our 73rd Republic Day, it comes as a heyday when we feel privileged of having achieved something great and precious. The people, being the supreme power, take the nation across the progressive path, feel responsible and honorable to be a part and parcel of this great nation that triggers the nationalistic fervor. Responsibility is that breeze that blows straight away to broaden the true identity of the nation. Republic, the word itself, instills in the people the sense of pride and oneness. Every individual has the supreme power to have the freedom of speech and freedom of action to put forth and reflect the brilliant ideas into actions, and thus embellish the nation with the crown of jubilance. Ever since India got independence, the main celebration of the Republic Day has been held at the national capital, Delhi, at Rajpath, in the presence of President, Prime Minister and all the other high-ranking officials. As we know, India got independence on 15th August 1947. The country didn't have its own constitution. Instead, India was governed by the laws implemented by the British. However, after many deliberations and amendments, a committee headed by Dr. B.R. Ambedkar submitted a draft of Indian constitution, which was adopted on 26th November 1949 and came into effect on 26 January 1915. On the same day, Dr. Rajendra Prasad also began his term as the first President of India. As a tribute to India, on Republic Day, ceremonial parades take place at Rajpath. The military parade starts from the Vijay Chowk and culminates at the Red Fort in Delhi. The weapons and the equipments that are shown by our army in the parade reflect the power of our armed forces. On this day, the medals and the awards for bravery are given to the armed forces and to civilians too. The main attraction for the bravery awards is the young children who are awarded by our Prime Minister for their ultimate bravery, besides being young, who have saved the lives of other people. This day is celebrated in every school, college, office and everywhere with great enthusiasm and energy. But beyond it all, our constitution declares India as sovereign, socialist, secular and democratic republic. It assures its citizens justice, equality, liberty and fraternity. On this prestigious occasion, the freedom fighters of our nation are not forgotten, who have dedicated their lives to save the country at any cost. So let's take a pledge that we all will maintain peace and harmony and must remember the sacrifices of them so we can value this freedom that we got because of them. Before I conclude my speech, I would like to say, patriotism is just like a charity. It must begin at home. Wish you all a very happy Republic Day. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.
Freedom of mind is the real freedom. A person whose mind is not free, although he may not be in the chains, is a slave. On this auspicious occasion of Republic Day, I, Yashika Suryavanshi of Class 8C, would like to convey my greetings to all our countrymen and pray for the prosperity and overall development for our country. It is always a matter of pride for us Indians to showcase our history and culture. Our history tells us about the stories of many heroes. One such hero is Dr. Bhim Rao Ramji Ambedkar. He is one of the most influential personalities all over the India. He is also referred as the father of Indian Constitution. Ambedkar was born on 14th April 1891 to Ramji Maloji Sakpal. He was born in Mahar caste, which were treated as untouchables and were subjected to socio-economic discrimination. With his long and pragmatic vision, Ambedkar drafted the constitution and gave the citizens of India constitutional guarantees. Baba Saheb mainly focused on the justice of women and lower caste. To him, society is just a society regardless of its caste, which is based on the principle of social justice and three main components: liberty, equality, and fraternity. India's constitution is one of the best democracy all over the world. It came onto the force in 26th January 1950. It is celebrated as Republic Day and a national festival all over the India. And on this note, I would like to conclude with my speech with pride in my heart and smile on my face. May this Republic Day bring prosperity and good health to all our Indians. May you all have a patriotic day ahead. Thank you all. Jai Hind.
दुश्मनों से हम लड़ेंगे, जुल्म अपना हम सहेंगे, हिंदू मुस्लिम सिख ईसाई मिल के सब आगे बढ़ेंगे, आदियों को चीर के रोशनी बन के रहेंगे, दुनिया में कर जाएंगे अब हम वतन, वंदे मातरम
वंदे मातरम वंदे। Jai.
A warm welcome to everyone who are watching this video. I am Gaurav Tripathi. Have you ever imagined how diverse our country is? With different languages and religions, and the person who has to look after India has a lot of pressure. But to make his or her work easy, a book is written of 170,396 words named Constitution. On hearing the word Constitution, many questions arise in our mind, like what is Constitution, who made it, when it was made, and much more. So, the Constitution is a set of rules and instructions according to which a government is run. It was made by the drafting committee under the guidance of Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar. It was first adopted by the drafting committee on 26th November 1949. Later, it was forced on 26th January 1950. Therefore, we celebrate Republic Day on 26th January every year. Thank you.
Going to my teachers. A super bath, my name is Janam.
I can't chiraman.
My name is Chiraman. My desk is the other week. Nantanta Devaski, so come and in a chat.
This month, the Sarah country has completed her 73rd year as a Republic country.
You have been a Sata Hikam Kitan Dura. Us Fox say, Jab. And Rezo Ki, Gulami Sam, Juj, Lada et. Us Fox, my desk had Dohan Kiajarata.
Our country was called Golden Bird, and these birds with vibrancy, beauty, and glitter were settled down by Britishers. After a bright sparkle, our leaders and national freedom fighters revived it, and we are going to embrace it to you.
आज हम उस पुण्य भूमि के बारे में बात करने जा रहे हैं, जहां ऋषि और मुनियों का वास था, और जिसे सदियों से वेदों और पुराणों में देव भूमि के नाम से लाना की गई है। हाँ, ये उसी उत्तराखंड की सहजमी है।
This land is the origin of the sacred Great Ganges River, which starts a journey from Gangotri Glacier to covering thousands of miles to drain herself into Bay of Bengal.
चार धाम भी इसी स्थल पर स्थित है, जिसे वेदों में यह लिखा गया है कि इन्हीं की यात्रा करकर ही हम स्वर्ग की प्राप्ति कर सकते हैं। इसी पाम भूमि पर बैठकर ऋषि वेदव्यास ने महाकाव्य महाभारत भी लिखा था।
उत्तराखंड से अंदर पाए स्नोवी हिमालय रेंज एंड एवरग्रीन शिवालिक हिल्स। It is home to Kanchenjunga, India's highest mountain, and Nanda Devi, the second highest mountain of India. It is also home to Brahma lotus, which is a rare flower.
यहाँ पर विश्व प्रसिद्ध जिम कॉर्बेट राष्ट्रीय उद्यान भी स्थित है, जो अपने विशाल और प्रबल बंगाल भाग के लिए प्रचलित है, जो सिर्फ भारतीय सबकॉन्टिनेंट पर ही पाया जाता है। स्वर्ग का आभास कराने वाली फूलों की घाटी नंदा देवी के साथ यूनेस्को की विश्व धरोहर में भी शामिल है।
इट इज ऑल्सो फेमस फॉर इट्स कंजर्वेशन ऑफ फ्लोरा फौना लाइक इनफेमस इवेंट चिपका आंदोलन। इट इज ऑल्सो फेमस फॉर वुड कार्विंग एंड ऑर्नेटरी डेकोरेटेड टेम्पल्स and also a painting called Pahari painting.
बाल मिठाई यहाँ की प्रसिद्ध मिठाई है और जोंसर बावर यहाँ का प्रसिद्ध नृत्य है, जो इस राज्य का शोभा और बढ़ा देती है।
This is what the land of God is, magnificent, mystic and majestic. Thank you.
Shukriya.
And happy Republic Day.
पंजाब महान गुरुओं की भूमि है।
शब्दों के मेल से बना है। पांच मतलब पांच और आग मतलब नदी, ये पांच नदियों के नाम हैं। सतलुज, रावी, व्यास, चनाव, झेलम, मक्के की रोटी और सरसों का साग और भामरा यहाँ की शान है। बोले सो निहाल,
West Bengal is a state in the eastern region of India along the Bay of Bengal with over 91 million inhabitants. It is the fourth most populous state and the 14th largest state by area in India. The state capital is Kolkata, the third largest metropolis and the seventh largest city in India. West Bengal includes the Darjeeling Himalayas hill region, the Ganga Delta and the coastal Sundarbans. The state's main ethics are the Bengali and the Hindu Bengali, forming the demographic majority. Thank you.
Happy Public Day. My name is Ashani Garg. I study in class 3B and I am representing Assam.
Hey! Bhagwadi.
Hi, my name is Sukh Chobe from class 2B.
Hello, my name is Siddhi Chobe from class 2B.
We are showing the culture of Rajasthan. Let us explore the Rajasthan.
Rajasthan is a state in northern India. It is also called the land of king.
Hawa Mahal is famous place of Rajasthan.
Ghumar is a traditional dance folk of Rajasthan.
Do you know Dal Bati Churma is famous dish of Rajasthan?
It has many historical places.
Ram Ram Sir.
Ram Ram Sir.
Namaste. My name is Sarthak Sahu. I study in class KG to section A.
My name is Samar Sahu. I study in KG to section A.
Today on Republic Day, we dress as South Indians.
Famous food of South Indians are idli, sambar, dosa, bada and extra.
Famous festival of South Indians are Onam, Pongal, Vishu, Ugadi, etc.
Happy Republic Day to all of you. Thank you.
Presenting the preamble of the Indian Constitution. We, the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic, and to secure to all its citizens justice, social, economic, and political liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith, and worship, equality of status and opportunity, and to promote among them all fraternity, assuring the dignity of the individual and the unity and integrity of the nation. In our Constituent Assembly, the 26th day of November 1949, do hereby adopt, enact, and give to ourselves this constitution. Coming to the terms of the preamble, sovereign. The term sovereign means to be free from any foreign control and internally have a free government which is elected directly by the people and make laws that governs them. Socialist. The term socialist was added by 42nd Amendment in 1976. This means to have democratic socialism, that is, achievement of all socialistic goals through democratic, revolutionary and non-violent means. Secular. This term was also added by the 42nd Amendment in 1976. This means to have a relationship between the government and its people which is decided by constitution and law. The government respects all religions. Democratic. The first part, we the people of India, and the last part, give to ourselves this constitution, clearly indicates the democratic spirit even in the constitution. The government is elected by the people at all levels through a system of universal adult franchising. Republic. In a republic form of government, the head of the state is an elected person and not an hereditary monarch. This term denotes that no one holds a public power as proprietary right. Liberty. The idea of liberty refers to the freedom given to the activities of Indian nationals. But this doesn't mean to have freedom to do everything and therefore must be exercised under constitutional limits. Equality. This envisages that no one holds special privileges and every individual gets equal opportunities without any discrimination. All are equal in the eyes of law. Last but not the least, fraternity. This refers to the feeling of brotherhood and belonging to one's country among its people. Thank you.
With every passing day, the obviating teens often did their grievances away in acknowledging and admiring the leaders of India, which leads patriotism to dwindle to a trickle. To rekindle the same, I, Anshika Malviya from class 11th B, am here to succinctly shed light on one of the most venerable leader of the country, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel. Before independence, India was bifurcated into provinces, but at present, after the whole partition fiasco, we live in a united, integrated and a commingled country. One of the remarkable freedom fighters who slogged years away in the quest of integration of the country was Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel. His peerless astute, coupled with a feeling of jingoism and a belief in unanimity, bore us the fruit of a diverse yet an inseparable India. This precisely is the reason why he is known as the Iron Man of India. Apart from accomplishing this Herculean and perturbing task, Sardar Patel had a zest for never stepping back from inciting and infusing nationalistic ideas into the minds and hearts of the people. This is another point of contribution of his to achieve the long-awaited freedom despite the despotic rule of British officials in those bucolic times. His ability to connect with the masses and his leadership qualities has led him to be called Sardar Patel, meaning Leader Patel. In a nutshell, our valiant hero's inclination towards not chiding his challenges away is irrefutably motivating, and his challenge contribution to attain freedom is unparalleled. Thank you.
Vandi, Vandi, Mataram, Vandi, Vandi. Thank you.
Greetings. This is Nakshatra Shukla from Class 9B, and today, on this auspicious day of Republic Day, I have been given the opportunity to recite the preamble of our Constitution. So here we go. We, the citizens of India, have solemnly decided to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, democratic republic and secure its citizens, justice, social, economical and political, liberty of faith, belief, thoughts, expression and worship, equality of status and of opportunity to promote among them all, fraternity assuring the dignity of an individual and unity and integrity of a nation. In our Constituent Assembly, this 26th day of November 1949, do hereby adopt, enact and give ourselves this Constitution. Thank you.
Good morning, one and all, respected principal, my colleagues and to my dear students. Today, on the auspicious day of 73rd Republic Day, I wish you all a very happy Republic Day. Republic Day of India is celebrated on 26 January every year. Dr. B.R. Ambedkar drafted the Indian Constitution, which was adopted on 26th, 1949. The Constitution of India took effect on 26 January 1950. After India gained independence. Republic Day marks the celebration of empowerment of Indian citizen. It is a national holiday that commemorates the process of establishment of the Indian Constitution. Since 1950, every year, January 26 is celebrated as Republic Day in India. It was on this day in 1950 that the Indian Constitution came into existence. An interesting point to note here is that India got independence on August 15, 1947 from the British rule. However, it was on 26, 1949 that Indian Constitution was first adopted. But the integration of this big nation and unifying the wide variety of cultural diversity was not done until January 26, 1950. That is when Indian Constitution came into existence. In light of this, it is important to understand what the Constitution is for. The Constitution of India is a huge document that lays down procedures, powers, duties, fundamental rights, and directive principles of the government of India and Indian citizens. The governing principle of Indian Constitution is of the people, for the people and by the people, which signifies the power which is vested in the hands of Indian citizen. With the Constitution, we have the right to vote, which makes India a democratic nation. Now let's talk about Republic Day in 2022. From this year, Republic Day celebrations will start on January 23rd, the birth anniversary of Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose, and will end on January 30th, the day Mahatma Gandhi was assassinated. New Delhi, the capital of country, will host the Delhi Republic Day parade organized by the Ministry of Defense. An array of 9 to 12 regiments from Indian Army, Navy and Air Force will parade in all their finery and decorations. Taking the salute will be the President of India, who is the Chief of the Indian Armed Forces. This parade will also feature 12 contingents representing the various paramilitary forces of India as well as police forces. On the eve of Republic Day, the President of India will distribute Padma Awards to the civilians of India.
Let's give a huge round of applause to all these wonderful singers for these compositions and for these presentations. It was really wonderful. Republic Day, it evokes in us a feeling, a sense of responsibility. It is our social responsibility to take care of each other, to love each other, to stand by each other, to stand in unison, to reach the acme of success. The eventual goal is progress everywhere. That is what is a sense of responsibility too. For that, which path we choose, that is more important. So on this occasion, I am so thankful to each one of you who has been the part and parcel of this Republic Day celebration. I extend my gratitude to our principal, Sister Marin, to give us opportunity for these wonderful presentations. Thank you so much. Once again, I wish you all a very happy Republic Day. Thank you so much. Jai Hind.